This is the testimony of my older brother Alex. Before I start to talk about his life-changing event, I want you to know who he was first. I probably let you watch the following footage and see for yourselves.
So today I'm gonna show you guys a cool magic, okay?
Hey guys,
you guys wanna see some magic?
Yeah.
You wanna see some magic, huh? You know, like a thing of
no.
Card. I would like to shuffle card in a different way,
cool
okay?
Magic.
That's a cool magic. Oh my god, yeah. Okay, so I gotta shuffle cards like this, okay? Face up, face down, see? It's really messy. You see that? Really messy. Some card face up, some card face down, okay? I would like you to pick one face up card. One face up card. Anything, okay. Don't let me see it. Okay. Show to everybody, show to the camera, okay? No camera check. You know, real stuff, okay, ready? Okay, put it back somewhere in the middle, right here, you know? So, facing down?
Yeah, I think.
No, kind of losing in the deck, you know?
Dude,
it's still messy, right?
There's
see?
Cookies,
some card face up, some card face down, one more time, okay?
Can
you give me a hand?
Only for the kids.
Okay?
Oh, no.
Cover with the cookie. Cover with the cookie and your other hand, okay? Ready? You feel anything?
Aaron, go grab me one.
No. Just pretend you feel something, okay? Just say, oh, I feel something. You feel something, right?
Yes.
Oh, cool. Okay. Grab the cookie out.
You said that on video.
Okay. Now watch.
I can hear you.
So, what was your card? Tell me. What is it?
Queen of Hearts.
Queen of Hearts, right? Whoa, watch this. And all cards seems back to normal. See? Whoa. Oh my god.
Ooh.
And one card is missing up.
That was Queen of Diamonds.
Yeah.
That was Queen of Diamonds.
Oh my
it was the Queen of Diamonds, right?
Not
Queen of Hearts. Queen of Diamonds.
Oh.
Magic. Other hand? Okay, nice, okay. Do you anything?
Yes, I something.
I don't know what it is. Okay, wait. Look. And all cards seems back to normal.
Whoa. Oh my.
Yeah. Oh my.
Oh,
is that
a card?
On top here, okay? Now I'm gonna make it disappear. Watch. Okay, watch. Now
nice guy.
Wait.
To make the cup vanish is easy, but the hard part is to bring it back.
Alex Wu.
search your mind. I want you to think of any number. Any number between 1 and 1,000. Any number. Okay? You have it in your mind? Yeah? Try to read your mind. I want you to concentrate. Look at me. Look at me in a sexy way.
Say this card is Ace of Heart. So I placed the Ace of Heart in Joey's hand. My assistant Joey. Oh, handsome man, huh? Okay, place the Ace of Heart right here. And I use another card to do the trick. Watch. If I do this, they change places. Now I have the Ace of Heart. And he got the Eight of Hearts. And now I will show you the secret. Okay? So here's the secret. All you need is just two cards. Okay, one is Ace of Heart, and the other one is Eight of Heart. Because people already confused, you know, by listening, okay? Eight of Heart, Ace of Heart, you know, they sound the same. But when you do the trick, okay, watch, Ace of Heart right here, right? If you do this, that person's freaked out. He got scared. In that split second, that's how you switch the card, okay? Let me do one more time. It requires a lot of practice. And a lot of meditation. And of course, you know, practice is the most important element in the performance, okay? Go ahead, show them the card, the Ace of Heart and the Eight of Heart. Now we're gonna switch it, okay? Ready? Go ahead, ready? Just like that, and he got freaked out, right? You see that? You see that? Now I just switched the card.
On the week of May 24th, 2019, my older brother Alex was very sick. Then at that night, my grandpa told him to visit the hospital due to his unusually high blood pressure. When he was being examined at the hospital, he got a stroke. One of my brother's friends sent me a message and said he had a serious brain injury in the early morning. My brain at the time could not process what really happened, and I anxiously drove to the hospital to visit my brother. I'm thankful that my uncle and my brother's church friends were there to take care of him without sleep. When I arrived at the hospital, this was what I saw. My brother, who was outgoing, funny, charismatic, and witty, lay on the bed unconsciously with multiple tubes and machines to sustain his fragile life. The doctor said he suffered extensive left brain damage and it was not going well. My parents at the time were both in Hong Kong, so when the doctor asked me to make all the decisions, my mind went numb. Since my brother's brain was gradually swelling and building up brain pressure, the doctor asked me if I wanted to consent to the surgery to remove my brother's skull to relieve the pressure. I remember vividly what the doctor said to me. He said your brother's brain is severely damaged, so even if he survives, he may not be the same brother you used to know. He may have to rely on the machine for the rest of his life in the vegetation state. It was up to me. I would not do the surgery and let him pass away. Afterwards, I went to the restroom and called an auntie in my church, and I sobbed. I thank God that a lot of church friends visited and prayed with me. A lot of people visited my brother as well. They wept, talked to my brother, played Christian songs for him, read the Bible for him, and pray for him. The brothers and sisters in Christ there reminded me that God was there with us. We're not alone. I was worried about tons of things. I researched a lot about the main factors of stroke and noticed my brother almost hit all the risk factors. And he foolishly canceled his health insurance because he wanted to save money in his probation period of his job. I could not imagine how much he needed to pay for all the medical expenses kept piling up every day. What if we go bankrupt? What if my brother dies in a surgery? What if he never remembers us? I recall a few weeks ago he sent a Facebook post to help me ask for job opportunities. and he said he would buy working clothes with me if he was free. Interestingly, I also realized that day in the hospital was the day I spent the most time with my brother, since he was always busy battling with work. Who knew just a few weeks later, he was battling with death. Sometimes tears flow from my brother's eyes. The doctors said it was because of the medicines, but I still wiped the tears away and said to him, "It's okay, we're here." I remember I said to myself in my mind, I'd rather be bankrupt and have my brother's life back. The skull surgery was successful. However, later a doctor told me at midnight that my brother's heart was still too weak. Even after they injected the maximum dosage of medicines, he would probably die in 4 hours due to multiple organs failure. My mind went blank immediately and I lost all hope. But I thank God that a brother in Christ initiated to pray with me and let me put all things to God. I invited all my brother's friends to say goodbye. Around 20 plus people came at midnight. I thank God that the hospital staff allowed us to do so in the ICU. I don't know if you ever count down someone's life in front of you. That night I could not sleep and reflect all the moments I spent with my brother. 3 hours, 2 hours, 1 hour, then minus 1 hour, and so forth. The nurse said his heart began to recover a bit more, but he was still in critical condition. He still needed to be medically sedated to calm the brain. But with God's grace and power, my brother was gradually recovering. A few days later, the doctors said he didn't need the ventilator, he could breathe on his own. Afterwards, he didn't need to be medically sedated, as his brain reacted to the environment normally. A few weeks later, he didn't need the feeding tube. Even though later on he got contagious bacteria infection in his colon, and needed to do VP shunt surgery due to fluid in his brain, God delivered him out of the dangers every time. I thank God for the doctors, nurses, social workers, and the physical therapists to take good care of my brother and encourage us positively. I thank God that a lot of people came to visit us, pray for us, help us in different situations, send food for us, drive my dad back and forth to hospital, and use the Bible to encourage us. I thank God that he saved my brother from death, and he is able to act like a normal 10 years old person now. He still cannot process math, logical thinking, and language, etc. However, through this marvelous miracle, I was deeply moved by God's love and let me surrender my life to him alone later on. I don't know what you are facing in your life, but I can firmly tell you that Jesus Christ is the only salvation. My brother accepted Jesus years ago, even though later on he went astray from God. God still loves him and cares for him so much to bring him from death to life. Even though initially doctors gave up on him, God never gives up on him. He saved my brother from physical death, but more importantly, he is able to save us from spiritual death due to our sins. If we confess our sins, repent from our sins, and accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, we can reconcile with God with eternal life due to his holy and righteous sacrifice. I pray that God can open your heart if you haven't accepted Jesus Christ in your life. He saved my brother, and he will save you as well if you put faith on him alone.